we could really make an impact in a lot of different diseases for diagnosis. And so we had the possibility of a handheld device similar to a glucose meter that could detect proteins that are indicative of many different diseases. Current technology for protein detection, at least the most flexible methods and what is normally used in clinical labs, is typically requires trained technicians in laboratories, takes maybe 6-8 hours to do the analysis of protein levels. We were able to develop an assay where it could possibly do all this stuff with a handheld device in the future in only about 3 minutes or so. We have some assays that we use, so our methods to measure proteins in our laboratory, where we use chemistry to attach DNA strands. We design the DNA strands specifically for a certain purpose to come together in a certain way, and we can attach those chemically to antibodies. And those are made to very specifically bind to the protein that we're looking for. And so they can do that work, they can do the binding work. We can use the DNA to basically send a signal after that protein binds.
In the presence of the protein that we're trying to detect, we form a complex on the surface, and the DNA is kind of acting like a scaffolding that holds everything together. And so this puts the electrochemical marker that we have in close proximity to the surface. That's why it's called a proximity assay, right? And so then we get an electrochemical signal. If the protein's not there, that complex doesn't form, and we don't see a signal. What electrochemistry brings to the table that the other type of detection technology doesn't is that it's relatively low cost. It's able to be miniaturized, and so we're kind of looking into the possibility of making a handheld device for this assay, something that might be relatively easy to commercialize for point of care type of analysis.